Good afternoon, Chair of Chairs, members of honourable members of the Legislature and residents of Gauteng. I rise today to address Budget Vote 12 of the Department of Sports, Arts, Culture and Recreation. In recognising the significance of sports, arts and culture in our Gauteng communities, we have serious concerns about the financial management and priorities reflected in this budget. The Democratic Alliance is greatly concerned about the insignificant increase in the department's overall budget from $1.89 billion in 2023-24 to $1.9 billion in 2024-25. This essentially represents a decrease in real terms when considering inflation, at a time when artists and athletes are struggling due to the lack of meaningful investments. This budget is insufficient. Inevitably, the minimal budget increase will affect strategic priorities and the implementation of programs such as sport and recreation and library and archive services. How can we expect to develop sports and the arts in our townships when we are not adequately investing in programs designed for that purpose? The impact of a reduced budget on a department that failed to build any sporting facilities in the 2022-2023 financial year and struggle to maintain and refurbish existing ones will be devastating for the residents of Gauteng, especially in the townships. Additionally, cuts to the department's budget will continue to hamper its efforts to build and transform libraries into information, knowledge, and cultural hubs in our communities. The DA is also concerned by the cuts to critical conditional grants. The Mass Participation and Sports Development Grant, crucial for grassroots sports development, has been slashed from $124.7 million to $111.2 million. This short-sighted cut will directly impact township youth who rely on these programs for skills development and for positive engagement. Chair of Chairs, the DA believes in the power of sports, arts and culture to transform lives and communities, but this requires real investment, not empty promises. In this regard, the DA proposes the following solutions. Number one, redirect funds from non-essential administrative costs to bolster the Mass Participation and Sports Development Grant. This will ensure township youth have access to quality sports programs. Number two, implement a Township Cultural Hubs initiative, creating dedicated spaces in each major township for arts and cultural activities. This will not only nurture talent, but create jobs in the creative sector. Number three, partner with the private sector to establish a sports and arts entrepreneurship program, specifically targeting township youth. This will create pathways from participation to profession. Number four, increase, not decrease, the budget for community libraries. These are vital knowledge hubs that support education and skills development in our townships. Chair of Chairs, we cannot overlook the 1 million reprioritized in this budget. The DA is demanding complete transparency regarding the reallocation of these funds. We need to know if these funds are genuinely meeting the needs of our most underserved communities. In short, this budget falls short of addressing the critical needs of township development and job creation in the sports, arts, and cultural sectors. As a result, I cannot, in good conscience, endorse the 2024-2025 financial year budget because it represents missed opportunities and misplaced priorities. I thank you.